Good day, everyone. We are the Group B presenting the circuit transformation entitled Source Transformation, a deep understanding of its concepts and its application on electrical circuit. And we are Antonio Calvin Jan, Edmar Casnizares, Jan Regala, and Jan Vincent Villa. For the introduction, Jan Vincent Villa will proceed.
For a brief introduction, as you can see, and as we know, electrical circuits are so complex that an average person can't handle it easily. So that's why electrical engineers are made for. They tend to use techniques how to reduce the circuit's complexity into an analyzable one. There are networks, the theorems and principles such as Millman's theorem, Thevenin's theorems, and source transformation, and other theorems and that super beneficial to help on finding the missing values. In this experiment, it aims to discuss the theorems that the instructor assigned, which is the source transformation, in order for the students to determine what values are asked. This will vary on each of us on how they calculate each values using the formulas they learned from the previous study. The circuit composes of 10 elements, which is 6 resistors, 3 independent voltage sources, and 1 independent current source. The students was able to simulate this project by using the CircuitJS simulator. This project is a stepping stone for the students as an aspiring engineers that may help to understand the basics of electrical circuits for them in the near future. And for the theoretical background, Mr. Edmar will discuss it.
Let's proceed to the theoretical background of the experiment. In this experiment, the students were able to develop new sets of skills, synthesize, and be familiarized with different electrical engineering concepts and even application of them in a circuit simulator. The students' main concern is to develop an electrical network based on the network theorem, specifically source transformation using a certain number of meshes, independent sources, and resistors. For the experiments to be punctual, the students find the related researches that will serve as a guide to fully understand the experiment. This part of the experiment presents a brief review of a researches which is related to the experiment. All of the following researches about a specific topic are formulated by the students to fully understand the experiment. First research is all about source transformation. According to Circuit Globe 2021, source transformation is the process of replacing one source with an equivalent source to make it simpler and easy to understand and assess the electrical circuit. A practical voltage source can be converted to a practical current source, and a practical current source can be converted to a voltage source. Also, for any practical current, there is an ideal current source in parallel with the internal resistance or impedance. And for an ideal current source, this parallel impedance is infinity. And he also added that source transformation are implemented using Thevenin's theorem and Norton's theorem. Next study or research is all about independent source. An independent voltage or current source is an ideal circuit component that fixes the voltage or current in a branch, respectively to a specified value. According to Lemon 2009, the voltage and the current source are the direct sources. The direct source is further classified as an independent voltage and current source. Independent voltage and current source. And independent sources are the ones that do not depend on any other quantity in the circuit. There are two terminal devices that have a constant value. In example, the voltage between the two terminals stay constant regardless of all circuit conditions. And the strength of voltage or current is not changed by any variation in connected network, the source. In the connected network, the source is said to be either independent voltage or independent current source. In this case, the voltage or current value is fixed and cannot be adjusted. For the next research, it's all about Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff's law, according to McAllister 2017, Kirchhoff's law for current and voltage lie at the heart of circuit analysis. With these two laws, plus the equations for individual components, such as resistors, capacitors, inductors, we have the basic tool set we need to start analyzing the circuit. Kirchhoff's current law is one of the fundamental laws used for circuit analysis. His current law states that for a parallel path, the total current entering a circuit junction is exactly equal to the total current leaving the same junction. This is because it has no other place to go as no charge is lost. And this idea by Kirchhoff is commonly known as the conservation of charge, as the current is conserved around the junction with no loss of current. And the next law formulated by Kirchhoff is all about Kirchhoff's voltage law or KVL. This is the second law that deals with the conservation of energy around a closed circuit path. Its voltage laws state that the algebraic sum of all voltage around any closed loop in a circuit is equal to zero for a closed loop series path. This is because a circuit loop is a closed conducting path, so no energy is lost. In other words, the algebraic sum of all potential differences around the loop must be equal to zero. And this idea by Kirchhoff is commonly known as the conservation of energy. As moving around a closed loop or circuit, you will end up back to where you started in the circuit, and therefore back to the same initial potential with no loss of voltage around the loop. And lastly, the last research the students formulated is all about Ohm's law. According to Map Hugupta, a senior member of IEEE, Ohm's law is perhaps the most popularly known of all laws, principles, and theories of electrical sciences. The law served as a foundation for many studies about electrical networks up until now in our time. It was a result of an experiment made by University Professor George Simon Ohm, happened in the year 1800s. In modern technology, Ohm's law states that the current I flowing to a conductor is proportional to the voltage B across it. Or if we put it in a formula, I is equals to V over R. Ohm initially called the constant proportionality R as reduced length, but later renamed it as a resistance. So it's the end of the related research. Next part is all about methodology to be reported by Calvin Gianantoni.
So here in methodology, we will discuss about the circuit diagram and its components, installation process, and the simulation and calculations of the three set of given values. So first, let's proceed to the circuit diagram and its components. So as you can see here in our screen, you can see that it is the diagram that the students will use throughout the experiment. So at first look, you will see that they are all look like a parallel circuit. So it is the here is the component of the diagram. So the diagram is composed of six resistors and three independent voltage sources, one independent current sources, and it is composed of four meshes. So as you can see, there is no values given yet, but we will put different values as the presentation goes on or goes by. So let's proceed to the installation process. So as you can see here, on the first, we can see that R1 voltage source 1 and voltage source 2 are connected in series. And that combination is parallel to the series combination of voltage source 3, R2, and R3. And their combination is also parallel to current source number 1. So as you can see here in our diagram, that the voltage 1 and 2 have the same polarity. They go, the positive side is on the upper part. While on the voltage source 3, it is the opposite of voltage 1 and voltage 2. The polarity of voltage 3 is that the positive goes downward and the negative is in the upward. And for the current source 1, we can see that the arrow is pointing upward. So that is how the current flows in that branch. Next is that current source 1 is parallel to R6. And then lastly, R6 is parallel to the series combination of R4 and R5. So that is the whole look of the circuit diagram that the students will base on as the presentation goes by. So also in here in methodology, we will provide you 3 sets of different values so that the students will use in this experiment. Those values will be different on each set and will be solved by using a source transformation method. So let's proceed to the simulation and calculations of set number 1 that will be discussed by Edmar.
For the set 1, we have six resistors having a resistance of 5,000 ohms, 20 ohms, 130 ohms, 2,000 ohms, 1,500 ohms, and 8,000 ohms respectively. Aside from that, we have 3 independent voltage sources having a voltage of 60 volts, 40 volts, and 15 volts respectively. And lastly, a single current source having a 10 ampere. After simulating this circuit, we get these measured values. First is for resistor 1. We measured the voltage and current that flows through it. First is the voltage drop of R1 is 1.227 kilovolts, and the current flowing through it is 245.414 milliampere. And for R2, the voltage drop we measured is 179.4 volts and a current of 8.952 ampere. And for resistor 3, the measured values we get is 1.164 volts, and for the current flowing around it is 8.952 ampere. For resistor 4, we get the measured values of 209.653 volts in its voltage drop and a current of 139.769 milliampere. And for R5, the measured values we get is 1.118 kilovolts for its voltage drop and IR5, and the current flowing to resistor 5 is 139.769 milliampere. And for R6, the measured values we get is around 1.326 kilovolts, and the resistance flowing through it, the current flowing through it, is 662.794 milliampere. So these are the measured values we get after simulating the given electrical network. After that, we solved the electrical network to get its calculated values using source transformation. For R1, as you can see in the diagram, we combine the first two source voltage sources since it is in parallel, and combine all the series resistors around the whole circuit. It's R2 and R3 and R4 and R5. So we get the sum of R2 and R5, a 150 ohm, and the R45, about 950 ohms. After that, we transform the 15 volts current voltage source into a current source by simply using the Ohm's law. By dividing the 15 volts all over 150 ohms, we get the 0.1 ampere for each current source. As you can see in the diagram, the current source is pointing down because of the orientation of the voltage source. After that, we get the resistor 456 using the formula for parallel resistors, and get the answer of 1652.1739 ohms. And after that, we combine all the current source and get the equivalent resistance of the given resistors. So we get to the 9.9 ampere for the total current source and 137.5151 ohm for the R23456. And after that, we transform the current source to voltage source by simply multiplying it to its resistors, and we get the equivalent voltage source of 1361.3995 volts. And using Kirchhoff's voltage law, we get the equation of 1361.3995 minus I times the sum of all the resistors, and we get 245.53 milliampere. And to get the voltage drop that the R1 have, we simply multiply it to its resistance, and we get the product of 1227.65 voltage. Next, for the source transformation that happens for R2 and RR3. Isang voltage source na lang po yung ginawa namin since naka-series naman na po sila and they have same current lang naman. So for this, we transform the first voltage source, the 60 and 40 volts, and its sum is 100 volts. To get the equivalent current source of it, we simply divide the voltage source to its resistance. 100 volts all over 5,000 ohm is equal to 0.02 ampere. And after that, hindi natin pwedeng pagsamahin yung dalawang naka-series na R2 and R3 since sila yung hinahanapan natin ng current na nagpo-flow sa kanila. So, next na ginawa namin dito is pinag-add namin yung R4 and R5 since they're in parallel. And after that, we get the next source transformation by getting the equivalent total resistance of R4, 5, and 6, and we get 1,652.1739 ohm. And we simply combine all the current source and get the equivalent resistance of R1, 4, 5, 6, and we go to this last source transformation. The sum of all the current source is 10.02 ampere, and nagkamali pala, yung sagot pala is sa R1456 is 1241.83 ohm. And after nun, transform namin yun by simply multiplying it by 10.02 ampere, and ako na nag-lead kami dito sa last na the source transformation. And using KVL, nakuha namin yung equation ng 12443.1366 plus 15 minus I times the sum of all the resistors, and we get the current flowing to IR2 and IR3. Calculated value is 8.951 ampere. And to get the voltage drop, according to the voltage drop that the these two resistors have, we simply multiply it to their given value. 8.951 times 20 is equals to 179.02 volts. It is the voltage drop we get in R2, and R3 by multiplying 8.951 ampere times 130 ohm, we get the voltage source 1,163.63 volts. And next, for the IR4 and IR5, dahil ginahanap natin is yung RR4 and RR5, pwede natin i-transform yung mga voltage source, no? So, tinransform po namin yung VR1, ay VS1, VS2, and VS3. And we get the value, the equivalent current source to voltage source 1, 100 volts or over 5,000 ohm, it is equal to 0.02 ampere. And next voltage source is the 15 volts divided by the sum of 130 plus 20 ohms, because it is equal to 0.1 ampere. And yan, ayun lang yung transform namin. So after nun, pinagsama-sama lang namin yung equivalent current source. Kasi mayroong mga, yung iba, yung may isang voltage source na naka-arrow down. And we get the sum of the current source, 9.92 ampere. And syempre, kinuha din naman yung equivalent resistance up ng mga nakaparallel na resistors. And after doon, since hindi natin the current flowing to resistor 4 and resistor 5 yung hinahanap, hindi natin sila pwedeng pagsamahin kasi yun, para mas mapakita. And by transforming the 9.92 ampere current source to a voltage source, we simply multiply it to the 135.746 ohm. Ito yung nakuha nating equivalent resistance ng R1, 2, 3, and 6. After transforming, pwede na natin gamitan ng Kirchhoff's voltage law. And we we get this equation, 1,346.61 volts minus I times the sum of all the resistors. And we get a equivalent current flowing through each resistor, 0.13975 ampere or 139.75 milliampere. To get the voltage source, by voltage drop that R4 and R5 have, we simply multiply it to its given resistance by 139.75 milliampere times 1,500 ohm. It is 209.625 volts. And for voltage drop in R5, 139.75 times 8,000 ohm. And we get the voltage drop of 1,118 volts. Lastly, for the IR6, transform namin lahat ng voltage source into current source. Kagaya lang sa ginawa namin sa IR4 and IR5. And yun, pinag-add namin yung R4 and R5. And we get the equivalent resistance of 10,500 since R4 is 1,500 ohms and 8,000 ohms. And we simply get the sum of the current sources, 10 plus 0.02 plus minus 0.1, and we get the sum of 9.92 ampere. And by getting the equivalent equivalent resistance of R2, 3, 4, and 5, we just get the reciprocal, the sum of its reciprocals and raise it to negative 1 to get the 143.43 ohm. And you can see in the last transformation that we make, pwede nang gamitan ng formula ng parallel connections para makuha natin yung na pwede na siya gamitin ng current divider theorem. So 9.92, and to get the value of 2000 ohm or the R6, we multiply the total current source 9.92 to 143.43 all over the sum of the two resistors. And we get the current flowing through resistor 6, 0.66381 ampere or 663.81 milliampere. And VR6, at the voltage drop across resistor 6 is 1,327.62 volts. After getting the measured values and calculated values, we compared it to each other, and we get almost the same measured values and calculated values. Nakaiba lang sila sa konting discrepancy, siguro doon sa mga round off namin ng mga values after habang nagpa-process kami ng calculations. So for the set 2, it will be discussed by Calvin Jan Anton.
And so thank you for discussing set 1. So let's proceed to set number 2. So first is let's see the simulation of set number 2. And set number 2. So ganito po talaga guys sa online class, sir, may mga lang po unting mga hindrances pero ginagawa po namin yung mga kaya namin, sir. So habang hinihintay po natin, no. So yun nga, no, sa i-discuss ko lang ulit habang hinihintay natin. So sa experiment na to is same diagram lang po yung ginamit namin sa iba't ibang set. So nag-iba lang po kami ng mga values ng mga resistors and the voltages. So ayan, eto na, magbabalik na po tayo, sir. Let's go. So for set number 2, eto na po yung discussion namin. So as you can see here in our diagram, so ito yung pagbebase natin ng set number 2. So dito naman is yung mga values naman natin is iba na. So for R1, makita nyo na ang value na nilagay namin is 1.5k ohms or 1,500 ohms. So and sa voltage source 1 and voltage source 2, ang value niya is sa voltage source 1 is 80 volts while sa voltage source 2 is 50 volts. Sa voltage source 3 naman namin ay ang value is 20 volts. While R2 is ang value niya is 500 ohms And R3 is equal to 800 ohms. And sa current source namin is 15 ampere. 15 ampere lang sa current source 1 ng yep. And edit lang po natin, no? So may mga unting ano lang talaga, sir. Ayan. So sobrang flexible namin, sir. Ganito po talaga. So sa current source 1 is ayan, 15 ampere na. And then sa R6 is 3K ohms. Sa R4 is 2K ohms. 2K ohms. And sa R5 is 5K ohms. So sa-simulate muna namin yung mismong set 2 para makita natin yung mga values na nagra-run sa kanila. Okay? So, mamaya i-confirm natin siya sa calculation natin if nagtugmama sila. So for R1, as you can see, na yan, nag-simulate na. Yung flow ng current niya is pababa, dumadaan siya sa ganyan. And then, sa R1, nung nag-flow na siya sa R1 na mayroong 1.5K na ohms, ang na-measured naming voltage drop sa kanya is 7,752 volt or 7.752 kilovolts. While tas yung current naman na nagpo-flow sa R1 is 5,168 milliampere or 5.168 ampere. And then for R2 na mayroong 500 ohms, sa measured values, makikita natin dyan is yung measured values ng voltage drop ng R2 is may na-measure tayong 3,339 na volts or 3.039 kilovolts. And ang current na nakuha natin sa simulation ng R2 is 6,079 milliampere. And then sa makikita naman natin for R3 naman tayo sa simulation ng R3, makikita natin na meron siyang 800 ohms. And nung sinimulate natin siya, yung current flow niya is pababa. Pababa yung flow ay pababa yung direction ng current niya. And then na-measure natin values ng voltage drop ng R3 na mayroong 800 ohms ay 4,863 volts or 4.863 kilovolts. While sa current naman na dumali sa kanya is 6,079 milliampere. So mapapansin nyo, yung R2 and R3 are same sila ng current. So hindi na nakapagtaka yan since they are in series connection. So yan na magpo-proceed na tayo for R6 or R4 muna. R4 muna tayo para maganda. So sa R4 and R4 may kita nyo is that yung na-measure naming values niya, since nakikita nyo, 2K yan, so ang taas ng resistance naman nyo. So, may kita natin dito is that yung flow natin is mabagal din since mataas nga yung resistance natin. So, ang nakuha nating voltage drop sa R4 ay 2,252 volts or 2.252 kilovolts. While sa current na nagpo-flow sa kanya is 1,126 milliampere, which is same lang sila ni R5 since they are in series. And sila din yung may pinakamababang value ng current throughout the circuit kasi sila yung makikita natin malayo sa mga source, and then at the same time is matataas din yung mga value ng resistances nila. So nabanggit ko na rin si R5, so let's proceed to R5. Ayan. Sa measured values naman ng R5 na makikita natin dyan is yung voltage drop niya is 5,630 volts or 5.630 kilovolts. While sa current niya is same lang siya sa R4 na sinabi ko kanina, which is 1,126 milliampere. So lastly naman na sa simulation is for R6. Ayan. Sa R6 na yan, makikita natin na meron siyang 3K ohms. And in that na nakuha nating voltage drop sa measured niya is 7,882 volts or 7.882 kilovolts, while ang current niya is 2,627 milliampere. So yan yung mga measured values na nakuha namin throughout the simulation ng set number 2. So para ma-confirm natin na tama nga yung paggamit natin ng voltage ng source transformation, dapat mag-end up tayo ng same values or close values dun sa mga nakuha nating measured values. So now let's proceed to the calculation ng source transformation ng set number 2. Okay? Now, let's proceed to source transformation ng R1. Ng set number 2. Ayan. R1 ba yan? Yep, yep. This is the R1. So, guys, makikita natin. Guys, sorry. So, sir, makikita natin dito that the, ito yung main diagram na sinundan natin kanina. And then, as you can see, that the next diagram or the second diagram is that yung transform natin siya. So, yung R6, since ang hinahap natin is R1, hindi natin pwedeng galawin yung resistor ng R1. So, ang ginawa natin is pinag-combine natin yung mga pwede natin i-combine para mas mapadalin natin. Tulad ni R2 and R3, ginawa natin siyang series. So, pinag-add na lang natin yung resistor niya. And sa R4 and R5, since series sila, pinag-add natin and then parallel natin siya sa R6, which is, ayan, makukuha natin yung value is 2,100 ohms ng nila, ng resistance nila. So, okay lang yung ginawa natin, guys, as long as hindi natin ginagalaw yung R1, which is yung kinukuha natin. And then, as you can see, ito na yung pinaka-diagram natin dyan. And then, pwede na tayo ngayon mag-apply ng source transformation. So, nung nag-apply tayo ng source transformation, yung 20 volts is, in-apply natin siya ng source transformation sa 1,300 ohms. So, naging current. Since ang direction niya is yung positive nasa baba, so yung arrow niya is nasa baba din pag naging current na siya. So, ang nakuha nating value is, makikita natin dyan, 0.014 ampere, tapos nakaparallel na ngayon siya sa 1,300 ohms. Meanwhile, yung sa 15 ampere kanina tsaka sa 2,100 ohms, hindi natin sila ginalaw since para mas mapadali na lang yung gagawin nating source transformation. After natin mag-source transformation dyan, ngayon is pwede natin i-combine yung mga values nila using algebraic sum nila. Halimbawa ito, next na naging transformation dyan, dito makikita natin na pinag-minus natin yung 15 ampere sa nakuha nating current ni 0.0514 ampere since magkaiba sila ng direction. So, ang lumabas na natin ngayon is 14.9846 ampere. Tapos yung 1,300 kanina tsaka sa 2,100, pinaralel natin siya. So, nung naparalel na natin siya, isang lumabas niyang value is 802.94 ohms. And then, ito na nga, dun sa second to the last diagram, makikita nyo na pwede natin siya ulit i-source transformation. So, ang ginawa namin dyan is nag-source transformation kami kay 14.9846 ampere tsaka sa 802.94 ohms. Ayan. And then sa final diagram, makikita nyo, yun na yung pinaka parang final diagram nung source transformation namin. Makita natin values is na nakuha natin voltage na ngayon niya is 12,031.73 volts. And then, naging series connection na si 802.94 ohms. So, hindi natin ginalaw si 1.5 kilo ohms kasi yun nga yung hinahanap natin. So, just sa final diagram natin, pwede na tayo nag-apply ng KVL. So, yung in-assume natin direction is counterclockwise. Counterclockwise, tama. Then, by KVL, ang makukuha natin values is negative 130 since lumabas siya sa negative. So, plus 12,031.73 volts kasi lumabas sa positive minus I times the summation nung current ng nasa loob ng series which is si 1,500 plus 802.94. So, pag nakuha natin yan is magkakaroon tayo ng equation and then makuha natin yung value ni I is 5.17 ampere. Since they are series, we can assume that yung 1.5 kilo ohms or yung R1 is equal lang din siya sa total current na nakuha natin. So, sabihin, ang current ni IR1 is 5.17 ampere. And then, next is to find naman sa voltage drop ni R1 is, gagamitan lang natin siya ng formula ng Ohm's law, which is yung VIR. So, mumultiply natin yung nakuha natin current sa mismong resistance niya, which is 1,500. And then, mag-result tayo sa voltage drop ni R1 na 7.755 kilovolts. And ayan na nga yung makita natin na calculation natin for solving natin for resistor 1 which is same lang dun sa nakuha nating measured values. So, goods tayo dyan. And then, let's proceed to paano naman if yung mag-apply tayo ng source transformation kay R2 and R3. Ayan. So, sa R2 and R3 naman, since they are in series, we can assume na isang transformation na lang yung pwede natin magawa sa kanila. So, tulad nga anina, so nag-base lang kami, ay ganun din ang ginawa natin, is pinagsama natin yung mga pwedeng pagsamahin. Since si R2 and R3 inap natin, sila hindi natin pwedeng galawin. So, yung R4, R5, and R6, since hindi naman natin sila hinahanap, we can combine them together. So, ito na yung kanina, 2,100 ohms. And then, kinumbine din natin pala yung dalawang voltage source kanina doon, which is naging 130 volts na. And then, makikita natin yan, after natin mag-combine, pwede na tayo ngayon mag-apply ng source transformation. Si R1 na 1.5K, nag-source transformation tayo sa kanya kasama si 130 volts. Kaya naging parallel sila. So, ang naging value ngayon niya into current is 0.0867 ampere and naging parallel ngayon yung connection nila. Meanwhile, yung 15 ampere tsaka yung 2,100 is hindi natin ginalaw. So, para mas mapadali na lang natin yan. Tulad ng ginawa nating approach kanina, we can get the sum or the algebraic sum ng mga pwede natin pagsamahin. So, since pares naman sila na going upward yung current, pinag-add na lang natin yung current source nila, which is mag-result sa 15.08867 ampere. And then, yung 1.5 ohms and 2,100 ohms, we can parallel, since parallel sila, kunin natin yung parallel nila, which is 875 ohms. And then, yan sa diagram na yan, pwede natin yan ulit mag-apply ng source transformation. And then, pag nag-apply tayo ng source transformation, magpo-proceed tayo sa final diagram natin na nakikita dyan. So, ang magiging value ngayon ni 15.0867 ampere sa voltage is 13,200.8625 volts. And ngayon is naka-series na ngayon si 875 na kanya. So, dyan, since simpleng diagram na siya, pwede na tayo ulit mag-apply ng KBL tulad ng ginawa natin kanina. Then, by applying KBL, we can see na, eh na, yung apply na tayo. So, eh na, kung natin algebraic sum ngayon. So, nakuha natin is yung 20 volts positive plus 13,200.8625 volts minus I or yung current, which is sumunod siya sa flow ni ng in-assume natin and then summation ng resistances dun sa series na ginawa natin sa dulo. Sa dulong diagram. And then mag-result tayo sa I na or yung current na value is 6.0786 ampere or sabi natin 6.08 ampere. Since yung R2 and R3 ngayon na hindi natin ginalaw kanina is naka-series connection dun sa nakuha nating I, we can assume na yung I niya is same lang din sa kanila. So, ang nakuha natin values ngayon ni IR2 and IR3 is same, which is 6.08 ampere. And then, these are the values we will use to find their voltage drops as well. So, for the VR2, we multiply the current 6.08 ampere to its resistance, which is 500 ohms. And then, now, naging resulting voltage drop ng R2 is 3,040 volts or we can say that it has a voltage drop of 3.040 kilovolts. While sa VR3, same process, we multiply the current to the resistance of R3 and we will result to 4,864 volts or 4.864 kilovolts, which is same values na nakuha natin kanina sa measured or close enough kasi may mga discrepancy siya since nag-round up tayo sa calculation. And now for R4 and R5. Ayan. So for R4 and R5, as we can see, isang transformation lang din yung nangyari since they are in series. So, tulad nga yung sabi ko kanina, we will combine dun yung mga terms, yung mga resistances na pwede natin combine. So, R2 and R3 is pinag-combine na natin since hindi naman siya hinanap natin. So, ayan yung magiging itsura niya sa diagram. Nung na-combine na natin, is may kita natin na hindi natin ginalaw si R4 and R5, which is kasi yun yung hinahanap natin. And then, mag-result siya ngayon sa pagka-combine natin, pwede na tayo mag-apply ng mga sa mga possible na pwede natin apply ng the source transformation. So, nung nag-apply tayo sa bawat isa, ito na yung mga lumabas sa kanya. So, you can see, parang naging parallel lahat sila. Since in-apply natin is yung mga naka-series sa kanila. So, ang value ngayon ng current dito is 0.0867 ampere. Tapos yung 20 volts kanina, in-apply natin siya ng source transformation, kaya pababa yung arrow niya. Pero ang value niya sa ampere is 0.0154 ampere, while yung 15 ampere is hindi natin ginalaw since naka-current source na rin siya para mas madali. And then, ngayon is naka-parallel na siya. So, tulad natin kanina sinabi ko kanina, we can combine those resistors na pwede natin combine and get the parang total current source na tumatakbo sa buong circuit. So, by doing that, magpo-proceed tayo sa ikatlong diagram. Makikita natin dyan. Which is na pinag-add natin, ikuno natin yung algebraic sum nila. So, ang resultant current source nila is 15.0713 ampere. And, makita natin, kuno natin yung parallel values ni 1.5K, 1,300, tsaka ni 3K. Yun yung kinuha natin parallel values na nag-result sa 565.22 ohms. And hindi natin ginalaw si R4 and R5 since yun nga hinahanap natin. And then yung nakuha natin values, pwede pa tayo mag-apply ng source transformation dun sa dalawa na hindi naman hinahanap. So, ang magiging final diagram natin is, yung magiging value ngayon niya in volts is 8,518.60 volts. And nakaseries na ngayon siya sa buong diagram. So, dahil madali na lang yan, we can apply KVL. And we assume that nag-assume tayo na ang direction ng KVL natin is clockwise. And then by clockwise, ito na nga yung values na ako natin, 8,518.60 minus the current. Since yung flow ng current is sumabay, so maging minus siya, plus the summation ng current sa series diagram sa dulo. And then, ang mga kuha natin value ni I ngayon is 1.1260 ampere. So, since naka-series sila, we can assume that R4 and R5 is also have the same current that flowing through them. So, IR4 and IR5 have 1.13 ampere respectively. And then, we will get now the voltage drop on each resistor or on R4 and R5. So, we will use the current na nakuha natin kanina para makuha natin voltage drop nila. So, for voltage drop ni R4, minultiply lang natin siya sa ohms niya, which is, or the resistance niya, which is 2,000. And then, nag-result tayo sa voltage drop ni R4 na 2,260 volts or 2.260 kilovolts. While si R5 naman is minultiply din natin yung current na nakuha natin na 1.13 ampere multiplied to 5,000 resistance niya, and we will result to 5,650 volts or 5.650 kilovolts, which is same din sa nakuha natin na values ng measured values. So, masabi natin na tama yung ginawa nating source transformation. Then, lastly, for set number 2, si R6, para makuha natin yung voltage drop and current ng R6, ito yung naging itsura ng source transformation niya. So, since si R6, sulod na sabi ko kanina, pwede natin pagsamahin yung mga pwede natin pagsamahin. So, ito na yung mga values nila. And then, it will proceed to this. That second diagram na nakikita natin dyan is na naka-parallel sa lahat. Naka-parallel lahat sila since nag-apply tayo ng kanya-kanya nilang source transformation. And then, makikita natin na values niya is 0.0867 ampere na ang flowing ng current is pataas. And naka-parallel siya sa 1.5 kilo ohms. And yung 20 volts kanina is dahil nag-apply tayo ng source transformation for R2 and R3. Ang magiging value niya ngayon is 0.0154 ampere and naka-parallel na ngayon siya sa 1,300 ohms. And yung 15 ampere kanina is hindi natin ginalaw para mapadali na rin. And yung R6 na hinahanap natin, which is 3K, hindi natin siya ginalaw since yun nga hinahanap natin. Pero si R4 and R5, we combine them kasi yun yung para mas mapadali. So, since series sila, pinag-add lang natin values nila, which results to 7K ohms or 7,000 ohms. And then, lastly, ito yung magiging final diagram ni R6. Pag kinuha natin yung algebraic sum or yung sum nung current source na tumatakbo sa diagram na yun, and then yung parallel resistances ng mga batsa. So, ang value ngayon niya is 15.0713 ampere and naka-parallel siya ngayon sa 3,000 ampere, which is hindi natin ginalaw. And then, yun ako ating parallel values ng mga pinagsama natin is 633.41 ohms. And then, as you can see, naka-parallel na siya. So, we can use, kahit hindi na tayo mag-KBL sa kanya, we can use the current divider theorem na natutunan natin sa parallel circuit or parallel series. Parallel circuit. So, IR6 is, so, kunukuha natin is yung current ni IR6. So, yung formula dyan is yung current na dumadali sa kanila is yung multiply natin, multiplied by 63.41 over summation nung the summation of all the resistances on the final diagram. And then it will yield to the result na ang IR6 natin is 2.6274 ampere or 2.63 ampere, which is same din sa nakuha natin kanina value ni R6 sa measured values. And then for finding the voltage drop ni R6, so simpleng ohms to lang ginamit natin dyan is V equals IR. So multiply the value of current ni 6, which is 2.63, times the resistance of R6, which is 3,000. And if after we multiply that, we will result to a value of 7,890 volts or 7.890 kilovolts, which is close or same to the values we get on the measured. So that's how the calculation on the source transformation on R1 and R6 for set number 2. Now, we will proceed for the last set, which is the set number 3 na i-discuss ngayon ni John Vincent Villan.
So, here in set 3, as we can see, that the two set of presenters, that the diagram is almost exactly the same. And alam mo, just speaking Filipino, sir, ito lang po namin yung mga values, sir. Pero certainly, sikap din po yung ginawa namin para makomplete po yung mga inaalat na values. So, here po, sa R1 po, sa measured value, ay sa given values na nilagay ko po ay meron po tayong 10,000 ohms sa R1. Sa R2 po ay meron tayong 40 ohms, and sa R3 ay meron tayong 160 ohms. Sa R4 po ay meron tayong 4,000 ohms. Sa R5 naman ay meron tayong sa R5 ay meron tayong 16,000 ohms, and sa R6 ay meron tayong sa R4 po ay meron tayong 2,000 ohms nga. Kagaya yung sinabi ko, sa R5 meron tayong 16,000 ohms, sa R6 meron tayong 4,000 ohms. And yun po yung mga 6 resistors po natin. Tapos sa independent voltage source naman natin po, meron po tayo 80 volts sa meron tayong 120 volts sa voltage source number 1. Sa voltage source number 2 naman po, meron tayong 80 volts. Meron tayong 80 volts. Sa voltage source number 3 naman po, meron tayong 60 volts. At yun po yung mga bumubuo na 10 elements ng diagram na to. And kung makikita po natin, yung sagot, naka-positive po siya, positive sign po siya upward kasama ng voltage source number 2. And sa voltage source number 3 naman po, nakabaliktad po siya kung saan ang positive sign po ay naka-downward. Tuloy sa R2 at R3. And current source naman po natin, meron din tayong 70 amperes. Tapos kung pupunta naman po tayo sa makikita po natin na normal na sound ko. Low. Sorry sir, medyo mahina po yung internet sa ganitong oras. And setting aside, pumunta naman po tayo sa calculated values. Kung paano kinuha yung bawat resources and what is their voltage and currents. So, para mahanap po yung IR1 po ay pupunta po tayo sa diagram po na wala pa akong file dyan. Hello. Hello. Calculation. Hello. Hello. So, para mahanap yung IR1 po, as we said earlier, sa mga previous sets po na nangyari, lahat po ng values na naka-series po ay ipagdaan, at lahat din naman po ng parallels po ay pag-combine din po. So here in IR1 po, para makuha po yung IR1 ay kinombine po muna ang lahat ng, kagaya ng sinabi ko, lahat ng naka-series. So, kinombine po natin yung R2 tsaka R3, which is 40 ohms plus 160 ohms, resulting to 200 ohms. Tapos, kinombine din po natin yung IR4 tsaka IR5, which is 3,000 ohms and 16,000 ohms, resulting to 19,000 ohms. So that mapapadali po yung pag-solve natin sa IR1. Then next po, lahat naman po na we transform the 200 volt voltage source and 60 volt voltage source, and then makukuha po natin ay itatransform muna natin po yung 60 volt na voltage source, resulting to 0.3 amperes parallel to 200 ohms. And as you can see, makikita din natin na parallel din yung 4,000 ohms tsaka 19,000 ohms. Kaya kinumbine po natin siya using the yung Rn equals to 1 over R 1 over 1 plus 1 over R2 raised to negative 1. So nakuha po natin yung 3.3043 kilo ohms. Na kung ita-transform sa ohms is 3,304.3 ohms. And then next po ay i-combine po natin yung mga currents and ohms na magka-parallel sa isa't isa. So, as nakikita po natin yung 0.3 ampere tsaka na facing downwards tsaka 70 amperes na facing upwards. So, ang mangyari po ay i-minus po natin yung 0.3 amperes sa 70 amperes dahil mas mataas yung values naka-upward na value. So, resulting to 69.7 amperes. Then, ipag-a-add nga po ulit natin yung naka-parallel na dalawang resistor, which is 200 ohm, tsaka 3.3043 kilo ohm using the R total equals to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 raised to negative 1. So, magiging sagot po ay 188.59 ohms, and the current source is 69.7 ampere. So, para makuha na nga po natin yung para ma-transform po natin siya into KBL, ay ginawa po natin na tin-transform po natin yung current source to voltage source. Ang nangyari po ay, para makuha nga po natin ay, ginamit po natin yung I equals to voltage over resistance. So, 69.7 ampere, baliktad. So, ginamit po natin yung voltage equals to resistance times current. So, 69.7 ampere times 188.59 equals to 13,144.72 volts series with the 188.59 ohms. So, as you can see, by using KBL, in-add po natin yung 200 plus 13,144.72 volts minus I times 10,000 plus 188.59 ohms. So, kung makikita natin na naka-negative sign yung 200 kasi counterclockwise yung ikot po ng o daloy ng ano natin na circuit. Ayun po. So, ang result po ng IR1 na sinabi natin na 200, negative 200 plus 13,144.72 volts minus I times 10,000 plus 188.59 is 1.27 amperes, which is exactly the same dun sa diagram na pinakita kanina, na sinimulate kanina. So, sa V naman, kagaya nga ng formula sa Ohm's law to find V, okay, V equals to IR. So, V equals to 1.27 ampere, which is yung nakuha nating current kanina sa dito sa KBL, times 10,000 ohms, which is the resistance ng R1. So, makukuha natin yung 12.7 kilovolts. So, ayun yung calculated values na nakuha natin sa IR1. So, going to IR2 and IR3, IR2 and IR3 naman ay we assume that they are same amount of current because they are in series. They are in series circuit. So hindi natin ginalaw yung R2 and R3. Ginalaw natin yung 200, yung R1 tsaka yung voltage source 1 tsaka voltage source 2 resulting to 200 volts and 10 kilo ohms. Tapos ginalaw din natin yung yung R4, R5 tsaka R6. R4 plus R5 equals to, di ba, yung 19,000 ohms, tapos parallel sa R6, kaya ang sagot ay 3.3043 kilo ohms or 3,304.3 ohms. So, doon po nakuha yung sagot natin doon sa parallel sa R6, sa given sa R6. So, yung 70 ampere ay steady pa rin po. So, dito naman po sa 10 kilo ohms tapos 200 volts, kagaya ng sinabi ko kanina, pinag-add natin yung dalawang voltage source since they are in series, which is 120 volts plus 80 volts. So, ayun po. So, para makuha naman po natin yung itatransform naman po natin yung 10 kilo ohms and 200 volts to itatransform po natin yung 200 volts to ampere. So, ano nga po ang formula ng ampere, di ba po? I equals to V over R. So, ang nakuha po nating sagot dyan ay
10,000 ohms over 200 volts equals to 0.02 ampere parallel to 10,000 ohms. And ayun po, in-add naman po natin yung mga currents and resistances na parehas ng na pwedeng i-add or parallel to each other. Yung 70 ampere ay pwedeng i-add sa 0.02 ampere, which resulting to 70.02 ampere, and yung 3.3043 kiloohms, tapos 10 kiloohms ay ipag-a-add by the parallel formula, and we will get that 2,483.63 ohms. And then, so itatransform po natin yung 70.02 ampere to voltage, and then, so to get that, we will use the voltage equals to resistance times current, and it will result to 173,903.7726 series to 2,483.63 ohms. So, makukuha natin yung ganyang diagram. So, by using KBL, ipag-a-add natin yung 60 plus 173,903.7726 minus I times 160 ohms plus 40 ohms plus 2,483.63 ohms. And makukuha po natin sa resistance ng R2, makukuha po natin ang current ng resistance ng R2 ay 64.8 ampere. And as we said kanina, R2 and R3 are same because sila ay series. Nasa series na circuit. So, meron silang 64.8 ampere. And to, para naman sa B, para mahanap naman ng BR2 ay i-multiply po natin yung 64.8 na current to 40 ohms, which is yun yung ano, which is yun yung kanyang resistance ng IR2. So ang lalabas na sagot ay 2,592 volts, and i-transform natin siya sa kilovolts kaya magiging 2.59 kilovolts. Sa BR3 naman ay 64.8, i-multiply po natin siya sa 160 ohms na resistance ng R3. So, ang lalabas na sagot ay 10,368 volts or 10.37 kilovolts. So, ayun, ganun natin siya nakuha sa R2 and R3. So, going naman sa R4 and R5 ay hindi natin ginalaw yung kagaya ng ano, para mahanap yung R4 and R5, hindi natin ginalaw yung R4 and R5. So, bagkus ginalaw natin yung R1, yung R2 and R3, and then yung, so ayun, para makuha natin yung mga values nila, ay inuna muna natin na i-transform yung 200 volt sa current. So ang nangyari ay 10 over 200 volts equals to 0.02 ampere parallel to 10,000 ohms. And tin-transform din natin po yung 60 volts resulting to 0.3 ampere parallel to 200 ohms. And then given na yung 70 ampere, yung 4 kilo ohms, 3 kilo ohms, and 16 kilo ohms. So pinag-add po natin yung mga currents and resistances na makakapagbigay po ng o makakapagpadali po ng mga pag-solve dun sa R4 and R5. So, then transform po natin, ay, ipinag-add po natin yung 0.02, yung 0.3, tsaka 70 ampere. So, since nakababa nga po yung, ano, yung 0.3 ampere going downwards, so, minus siya dun sa 70 plus 0.02, resulting to 69.72 ampere. So, pinag-add naman po natin yung mga parallel resistances, which is 10,000 ohms, 200 ohms, and 4 kilo ohms. So, resulting to 186.92 ohms. And then, yung 69.72 ampere po dyan ay tin-transform po ulit natin sa voltage. So, para po sila ay maging series circuit. So, para makuha po natin yung voltage ay dinivide po natin sa pinag-multiply po natin yung 69.72 tsaka 186.92. So, resulting to 13,032.06 volts. Series to 186.92 ohms. So, ayan. Series na po sila. So, by using KBL po, ay makakuha po natin yung IR4. So, 13,032.06 minus I times 186.92 plus 3,000 plus 16,000 ohms resulting to 0.679 ampere or 679 milliampere. So, as we said kanina, dahil sila ay naka-series sa isa't isa, yung R4 and R5 ay magiging same sila ng values ng current. So, meron tayong current na 679 milliampere sa R4 and R5. So, para mahanap naman po yung voltage sa R4 and R5 ay sa R4, para mahanap po natin yung voltage sa R4 ay minultiply po natin yung 0.679 ampere sa 3,000 ohms. So, nakuha po natin yung 2,037 volts or para mapag-ikli ay 2.03 kilovolts sa BR4. Sa BR5 naman po ay minultiply po natin yung 0.679 sa 16,000 ohms niya and it will result to 10,864 volts or 10.86 kilovolts. So, ayun po yung result. Ayun po yung result na ginamit sa R4 and R5. Ayun po yung nakuha nating result sa R4 and R5 and such. Sa R6 naman po, sa last na ano ko po ay hinanap po natin yung R6. So, paano po natin hanapin yung R6? So, pinag-combine po natin yung lahat ng pwedeng i-combine, which is the B1, B2, and R2, and R3. So, it will result to 200 volts, 10 kilo ohms, 60 volts, 200 ohms. Ayun po. Tapos, pinag-add din po natin yung R4 and R5 na series sa isa't isa, resulting to 19 kilo ohms. So, dito naman po, tin-transform po natin yung 10 kilo ohms to, 200 volts to current. So, ang sagot ay 0.02 ampere parallel to 10,000 ohms. Tapos, tin-transform din natin yung 60 volts sa current, which is resulting to 0.3 amperes parallel to 200 ohms. And then, pinag-add po natin lahat ng pwedeng ipag-add and kagaya ng sa current ay meron tayong 0.02 ampere, meron tayong 0 going upward yon, and sa downward meron tayong 0.3 ampere, tapos sa upward naman ulit ay meron tayong 70 ampere. So, ayan. In-add natin sila and as you can see, yung naka downward ay ima-minus natin sa 70 ampere tsaka 0.02. sa result ng 70 ampere tsaka 0.02 ampere. And then it will result to 69.72 ampere. And lahat naman ng nakaparallel na resistance ay ipag-add din natin, which is the 10,000 ohms plus 200 ohms tsaka, hindi, yun lang muna, 10,000 ohms tsaka 200 ohms. Resulting to 196.08 ohms. Parallel to 4,000 ohms and 19,000 ohms. And then, pinag-add ulit natin yung parallel, nakaparallel na resistances. Which is the 196.08 tsaka 19,000 ohms. So, it will result to 194.08 ohms. So, ayan. Dahil mas madali yun para mapag-divide po natin o magamit natin sa kanya yung current divider theorem. So, this ay here, para makuha na natin yung IR, yung current sa R6 ay multiply natin yung current source, which is 69.72 sa 194.08 na resistance over 194.08 plus 4,000 ohms. And it will result to 3.23 ampere. So, kung hindi man nga po siya na parehas dun sa measured values kanina, ay meron nga lang po siyang konting dahil nga po sa mga pag round up po. Ayun lang po. So, sa para mahanap naman po yung BR6, ay pinag-multiply po natin yung 3.23 ampere sa 4,000 ohms, which results to 12,920 volts. Or, in short, 12.92 kilovolts. So, ayun guys. Ayun po, sir. Ayun po yung yun po yung paraan po ng pag-solve po sa set 3. And paano po nakuha yung mga calculated values po sa set 3. Yun lang po. Thank you po.
So for the clarification and additional information about the simulation, I'm here to discuss the simulation of set number 3. So here we can see that the simulation here in set number 3, the values are different from set number 2, set and set number 1. But the whole diagram is always the same. There are 10 components here, as we can see. There are 3 different independent voltage source and 1 independent current source. And there are 6 different resistors. And as we can see that when we run the simulation on the part of 2 batteries or the 2 voltage source, the current flow is counterclockwise. While on the second mesh here is also counterclockwise. But here on the mesh tree, where you can find the independent current source 1 and the resistor 6, it will be clockwise direction. The current will be clockwise direction. And also on the mesh number 4 that contains R6, R4, and R5, it will be clockwise direction. for the discussion of results and discussion, here we can see on table 1.1, it shows us the measured values of set number 1. And table 1.2 will be for the calculated values of set 1. So table 1.1 and table 1.2 represents the measures and calculated values of set 1. The same values are voltage drop of resistor number 5, current on resistor 2, and current on resistor number 3. There are both the same. For tables 1.3 and 1.4 respectively, it will be for the measured values of set number 2 and calculated values of set number 2. Since all the sets contain the same circuit diagram and flow of the current, the same kind of source transformation happenings in finding the voltage drop and current flow in each resistor, they will only result in different values since we only change the given values. For table 1.5 and 1.6, it will be the measured values of set number 3 and calculated values of set number 3 respectively. For the summary and conclusion, here we can see that the three sets having only one circuit diagram and set beforehand with six different resistors and three sets which are not the same values. As a result in progress, the values that are measured are almost equal to the calculated values because of some margin of error that produced when solving because of the methods used by the one that calculated it. The results also shows of some the values have plus 5 or minus 5 values because of the units used that will be converted. This means that the results are precise enough to say that this experiment is a success in giving the right values to test and to answer the missing values needed to compare the measured and calculated values. Also, as you can browse through the results from tables 1.1 to table 1.6, have a thing that should be taken care of. The measured and calculated values of current are always the closest to each other, while the measured and calculated voltage drop have the most difference among any other values. This is produced because the current on each resistor is the first one to be solved on the calculated values. Then its answer will be multiplied by the resistance of the corresponding current. Then that will be the voltage drop of each resistor. That is the reason why the voltage drop are the most or the highest difference between the two values. As for the conclusion, the source transformation is accurate in determining the values of each voltage drop in each resistor, current on each resistor, and the values of missing or required values to search for. This gives the electrical engineers to have a foundation to solve for error and avoid mistakes in solving a problem soon. Thus, the whole experiment that the experimenter did proves the efficiency of the source transformation if the circuit has different sources. This makes the one who will solve the missing values to have a more easier and accurate way. And that's for all.